What's up, everybody? My name is Vince. Welcome to the channel. And today, we have a special guest here. This is Big Brian, the King of the Crease.
What's up, everyone?
He's also known around our channel as somewhat of a rigid specialist, expert.
Yeah, you could say that.
He likes his rigid tools, and today he has a special treat. What do you have for us, Brian?
We have the new rigid Octane Impact 6 mode.
We're back, and Brian's ready to tell us a little bit more about this rigid impact driver.
Well, this one's new and improved over the Gen 5X. It has a little bit more power. Comes with your nice belt clip.
Single belt clip and a
single
screw.
One. They give you a little cardboard thing that tells you what all the modes are and what they're all about.
It looks like almost the same. Is it the same size as the regular Gen 5X?
It's the same size, yeah, pretty much.
Is there anything different in size that you could point out? Is the base plate any bigger? Or is there more light? Is there anything that you know off the top of your head that's...
No, it's pretty much the same thing, same as the Gen 5X.
Okay.
They give you the specs here, like speed one is 0 to 750 RPMs, speed two is 0 to 2200 RPMs, and speed three is 3000 RPMs, which is a slight improvement over the Gen 5X. Not much, but a slight.
Right.
And the instruction manual, which we don't need.
You know what I really like about the Octane line and what Rigid's doing right now? I feel like they're making more and more powerful tools. You know, although Rigid, their customer base is prosumer, this Octane line, and when we say prosumer, that's their customer base, right? They have some people that do DIY, consumer, and then they have pros. These are construction grade or contractor grade tools, okay? It just so happens the people that are buying them aren't necessarily all in construction. This is the deal though. I feel like these tools are getting more and more powerful, not necessarily more and more compact. I feel like they're maintaining that size.
Rigid has never been known to be a compact tool. They put their tools out there and it is what it is, but you know, they're not trying to chase after that compact market. They want power and size. And
this is the thing. I feel like TTI knows that there are a group of people out there that might be coming from other brands. Those individuals might equate bigger with better. Some people might look at a Makita tool that is more compact and powerful and say, it's just too small, that's a toy. It's not, you know, and Milwaukee, I feel, competes in that segment of very powerful, but very compact. And some individuals that are pros, they don't like that compact tool. Or maybe they have big hands like Brian, right?
Some people don't need a compact tool to get the job done.
Right. But. So they might have been hesitant in the past to jump from a different line of tools that was bigger into a Milwaukee line. And I feel like TTI is saying, yeah, let's give Rigid more power to make it compete with more and more contractor level tools. But let's maintain that size because some guys feel bigger is better. I feel that this is a strategic move. I don't ever see Rigid becoming a smaller or compact tool.
They're maintaining the same size as their old tool line. They're just giving it more power with the Octane so to compete with other brands, you know.
I will say this, and also with that more size, I feel like that has a better capacity for cooling.
Yes, it does. Has a nice fan inside. It feels better in my hand because like the Makita XDT16, the handle feels pretty small. Like I can't get my hand around. This is like the perfect size.
Gotcha.
And even some of the DeWalts, the handle feels a little small compared to this.
Really?
Yeah.
I literally feel like they're positioning this Rigid to compete with DeWalt. That's my opinion. I feel that for the Octane drill, maybe the impact driver, I feel they're literally positioning the power and size of this to compete in that DeWalt segment. I will say this, how does this get more power? Can you tell us a little bit about the batteries?
Oh yeah, you have to use the new Octane line of batteries. Now, these batteries have like a little computer chip or computer board inside of them. And as the tool needs more power as you're drilling, it draws more power from the battery as needed. And if you don't need much power, it's not gonna send as much power to the drill.
So you don't necessarily need, you could use any of the rigid 18-volt batteries,
right?
But to get the most out of this tool, you should be using
Octane.
Gotcha.
I mean, you can use even the old 4 and 5 amp ones, but they recommend you use the Octane since it is an Octane branded drill.
Gotcha.
And with these Octane batteries, they have the Octane app on your phone.
Oh, that's awesome.
Where it tells you the charge level, it tells you, it can locate the battery for you. You could lock it out if you want. You press swipe to lock, and it'll lock out the battery, so when you press the trigger, nothing's gonna happen.
Really?
Yep.
I didn't realize you had all that function.
Yep, and it tells you the temperature of the battery and the last known location, how many times it's been charged, when the last time it was charged. It gives you a whole bunch of good information on there.
Now, how do you see yourself running this tool? Do you prefer a smaller, like a 3 amp hour battery on this tool, or do you like to run maybe the 6? Like, how do you like to run your
Octane?
You know,
I find for impact, since you're mostly using screws and stuff and lags, the 3 amp's gonna be perfect because it keeps the tool nice and light if you're gonna be using it all day. It's not too bulky.
Right.
But if you need to drive like bigger fasteners and stuff for a long time, then you're gonna wanna go up to the 6 amp hour battery. The Octane batteries do come in a 3, a 6, and a 9 amp right now.
Let's take a look here. The Octane tool itself, without its belt clip, we didn't install that yet. You're looking at 2 pounds, 9.3 ounces, which is, I gotta tell you, although it seems like it's a bigger size, that's pretty lightweight for the tool, which leads me to believe that they're leaving a large capacity for cooling in there. Now, if you were going to run it like Brian prefers to run the tool, which I kind of agree, you wanted to put a 3 amp hour battery on there, you're looking with a combined weight of just over 4 pounds at four pounds, 0.9 ounces. And then finally, if you're gonna run it the way I like to run it, you throw that 6 amp hour battery on there. We're looking at 4 pounds, 6.2 ounces. Even with that 6, not that bad. This is pretty compact. This is a brushless tool, okay? For some of you that are not familiar with the Octane line. Let me see, is there any other specifics on here? It says an industry leading 2,400 inch pounds of torque.
Yep.
It does come, and now this is the thing. I don't believe they're offering, look at that, you see that? I don't believe they're offering this in a kit form just yet. So you're buying these tool only. And if you were interested in the rigid limited lifetime service agreement or lifetime service agreement, the LSA, when you buy kit form tools, so that means battery, charger, and tool, you get that lifetime service agreement on all the components. So even the battery has that lifetime service agreement on it.
Brian, only in kit form.
And only in kit form.
Right.
Right. The way Brian bought this tool was tool only, not in kit form. So that means he bought the batteries separately. Now, that means the batteries will not be covered under that limited lifetime service agreement. But you will get a warranty on the batteries.
3 years.
3 year warranty. So keep that in mind. If you're interested in the lifetime service agreement from Rigid, you're going to want to wait for kit form of the Octane impact driver.
It has two buttons here. One is for speed, so you have your speed 1, 2, and 3. And then your mode, you have an auto stop mode, which it shuts down after impacting to prevent over tightening. Then you have your fastener assist mode, which is it's a slow start with a speed ramp up for faster threading, mm-hmm. to maintain control, it says. And then you have a self-drilling screw mode. Speed ramps down once the fastener threads engaged material to prevent overdriving. Kind of like the Makita. The Makita Impact does the same thing. The XDT-16, XDT-12.
It has that auto feature.
Yep.
Have you ever actually had to use that lifetime service agreement? I want to know.
No, not on any of my Rigid tools. I've been using Rigid now, we're going on about 5 or 6 years now. I've been using Rigid, not one claim on my warranty for them yet.
Whoa. I like putting my belt clips on, or putting Brian's belt clip on. Yo, I tell you what, see this screwdriver? It's got 11 functions. One of them is hidden. Bet you don't know what it is, but if you wanted to find out, you could go on over to that video there. What else can you tell us about this
thing? And also, it has nice three LED lights up there, which are nice and bright. Mm-hmm. And I think these are better than the Milwaukee Gen 3, because the Gen 3 gives you one little light down here. And this is, and it has a separate switch down here. So you know, before you press the trigger, you just press the switch and the lights come on.
Listen, we weighed the thing up. We showed you what it weighed. Brian told you he likes the lights. We know what you really want. You want to see this thing run. You want to see some screws driven. You want to see fasteners. You know what you got to do, don't you? You got to go on over to that video there. Because I know we just unboxed it, but this impact driver's already been through a tool test raw. What's a tool test raw? Go follow that link and find out. With that, I want to say I appreciate every single one of you being here. Brian, thanks for bringing this here.
Anytime.
Yeah. We'll see how well your lights hold up in tool test raw.
We'll see.
Thanks a lot, everybody. We'll see you all on the next one.
Later, everyone.
Video's over, but I know you want more. So this is how you're going to get it. First thing you need to do is pretend you're this guy.
And you're here at the birthplace of freedom. Now ring that bell like it's 1776 and let all notifications through.
What? You're not subscribed yet? Well, smash this button here. After that, watch this video here, and maybe over here.
See you later.